pushing it out and paced me.
Denmark launches children's TV show about a man with a giant penis.
Oh my.
Isn't it interesting how it seems like other countries don't seem as stuck up as America is? Don't get me wrong, a show about a giant penis for kids is weird, but considering I can't say much of anything on YouTube and a penis cartoon show is totally fine in Denmark, makes you think, doesn't it? Critics condemn the idea of an animated series about a man who cannot control his penis, but others have backed it. Says, this is The Guardian. Oh, God. Whatever. John Dillerman has an extraordinary penis. So extraordinary, in fact, that it can perform rescue operations, etch murals, hoist a flag, and even steal ice cream from children. It sounds like a penis that could totally get chicks. This guy could just sit in cruise control and his dick does all the work. Yeah, this really doesn't make any sense. Like, it's not even a dick. It's like a snake. It's a rope that has a mind of its own. Can I see more of this? I actually need to see this show. What is this show? I gotta see. God, maybe I need to move to Europe. If this is fine in Europe, I could have a children's television show. The Danish equivalent of the BBC DR has a new animated series aimed at 4 to 8-year-olds about John Dillerman, the man with the world's longest penis, who overcomes hardship and challenges with his record-breaking genitalia. He overcomes hardship. See what they did there? Surprisingly, the series has provoked debate about what's good for children's television. Well, you know, don't get me wrong. I don't feel that this is I don't think a penis show is good for kids, but then again, maybe people in Denmark are better adjusted. Lord knows over here in America, sex is terribly bad. Unless a woman's profiting from it. I mean, didn't we have, like, queer kid stuff on YouTube for the longest time? I mean, there's been some weird shit going down. Since premiering on Saturday, opponents have condemned the idea of a man who cannot control his penis. Is this really the message we want to send to children while we are at the middle of a huge Me Too wave? Oh, that's still going on? Good Lord. Me Too's a lot like Gamergate. It just never ends. Ever. And like, what does John Dillerman, the clay man, have to do with that? He basically has like, as they say, a smart penis. I don't know. Can the penis do his taxes? How useful is this? It looks like it's barbecuing right now. And personally, I'm kind of hungry. Also, it's barbecuing wieners. Find that a little odd. Wait, why does a penis need ice cream? Is it eating the ice cream? John Dillerman doesn't have a dick. He has a parasite attached to his crotch, honest to God. Christian Groers, I probably got this wrong, an associate professor at the gender research at Something University, said he believes the program's celebration of power of male genitalia could only set equality back. How do you figure? I'm not saying this is great for kids. I'm just saying it's so stupid. You think like young boys are going to be empowered by it? They go, oh, I have a mighty penis, Stacy. I'm a man, hear me roar, sort of thing. Like, my God, there's never been any celebration of the penis. Every 5 minutes is celebration of femininity, but masculinity's gotta go. Good Lord. Like, women's nudity, it doesn't matter if the woman's good-looking or a fat pig. They would treat it like it's art. It doesn't matter. It's like, oh, women's naked bodies is art. But the man's naked body, unless he's like super good looking, he's in great shape, it's treated like this disgusting, vile thing. Don't get me wrong, I'm just playing the devil's advocate for this. I don't see how a clay penis show is going to set back equality one step. If anything, it's going to set back quality programming. Whatever. It's perpetuating the standard idea of a particular society and normalizing locker room culture. And yeah, God forbid, locker room culture. Remember that? Back when men were men? Where you went after you played sports? Oh, God forbid. You might work up a sweat and work some muscles. And as we all know, working out is oppressive. I'm not joking. That was actually an article. Gym toxic culture is all around you, and immediately staff should set the tone. Toxic masculinity in the gym? Yes, that's usually where testosterone is, you asshole. All right, let's just move on. That's been used to excuse a lot of bad behavior from men. It's meant to be funny. So it seems it's harmless, but it's not. And we're teaching this to our kids. Yeah, I don't think you're going to get that locker room mentality from John Zimmerman's Magic Penis Hour. You can tell this is a dude who's beaten up during gym. You can tell this is the guy who got his ass kicked. He was the one that everybody whipped with the wet towels as he ran out screaming. A clinic psychologist who works with families and children said she believes the show opponents may be overthinking things. John Dillerman talks to children and shares their way of thinking. And the kids do find genitals funny, she said. Alrighty then. It's weird that he like shares the way of thinking with kids and has a magic penis. A little strange to me, you know. The show depicts a man who's impulsive and not always in control, who makes mistakes, little kids do. But crucially, Dillermand always makes it right. He takes responsibility for his actions. When a woman in the show tells him that he should keep his penis in his pants, for instance, he listens, which is nice. He's accountable. That's probably one of the funniest fucking lines to an article I've seen in a while.